What's up, guys? My name is Chase Weatherford, and this is my first YouTube video. So if it's horrible, I'm sorry. But anyways, bear with me. I've been playing guitars for about 3 to 4 years or so, and in those years, I've bought parts from different places and things like that. And one of the parts I always had to buy was pickups. And pickups, if you've ever bought a set of pickups, a good set of pickups, you know that they can run anywhere from, I'm gonna say, 60 to as much as you want to spend on them. And you know, when you're building a guitar, you want good pickups and you want it to sound good. And so in my mind, I was thinking, hey, I'm gonna personalize my guitars more by building my own pickups. So that's what I decided to do. And in that process, I knew I had to build a pickup winder or buy one. And I like building stuff. So I thought, heck, I'll build one. So anyways, if you have a YouTube video on here about building a pickup winder, I can about guarantee you that I watched it. And thank you for that. And any chat rooms, anywhere like that, that had people talking about, pitching back ideas about building pickup winders and stuff like that, I've probably read it. So thank you too. Anyways, I'm going to show you right quick. It's not very pretty. It's ugly, but it works. And that's really, to me, that's all that matters. So if you want to build one like this, stick around. I'm going to go through all the parts, how I put it together, where I got the parts from, how much the parts are now. And I hope you enjoy. And leave me a comment if you do. Or a bad comment, I don't care. Just whatever you want to do. But thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. All right, here it is. And by all of its ugliness. But it works, and that's all that matters. I'm going to take the top off now and let you look at the inside of it. We're going to start with the three main components. The first one is going to be the motor. The second's the counter. The third is the speed controller right here. And there's a couple other smaller components. The switch, the rod, a bobbin holder, different things like that. I'm going to go through them with you. All right, the motor. I bought this on eBay. I want to say it was right at $15, 15 to 20 bucks. I'm running there. It is a 12-volt DC 1,000 RPM geared motor. And when I say geared, I mean it actually has gears. It's just not a motor just sticking out here with a bobbin on the end of it. I think the mechanical advantage gives you a little advantage on winding pickups instead of having, a lot of people build one and they have the motor sitting here and they have a pulley on it, and the pulley is going to another pulley that's giving it mechanical advantage to actually do what this motor's doing. Bought it on eBay under 15 or around $15, something like that. Make sure that's everything on that. This counter right here, I want to say I bought it on Amazon, but I checked this month, it was a couple days ago I checked, and this is January of 2018. I checked online. This was $12.49, and this is actually a five-digit counter. And some of the people online that I read some of the things said, go ahead and get a five-digit. You never know if you might need the fifth digit. I probably never will. Most of the pickups I wind are 7,000 to 9,000 wraps. If there's pickups out there, they're 10,000. Well, if you get this one, you'll be able to do that. The counter actually comes with a sensor and it comes with a magnet. And it's just a magnet. I mean, any magnet will work. You know, if you had a bunch of these made and you wanted to make a bunch of them, you could just buy different magnets for it. Like I said, it's a five digit. It's got a reset, a pause. Search it on Amazon, search it on eBay, see which one, where you can find the better price at. And like I said earlier, make sure that you check to see where these parts are coming from. If they're coming from China, it's going to take longer for them to get here. So that's about it on the counter. The speed controller. I actually searched online and found a 12-volt DC motor speed controller. It brought up a schematic. I used a schematic to build this. I had a lot of these parts. I had to buy this transistor, I believe. But not only when I bought it, I bought one. I got like 10 with it because they're cheap. So now I've got that part if I wanted to build another one of these or something. I did search on eBay. I searched on, eBay and found one that I believe would work with that motor. It was pretty cool. It had a little bitty chipboard with a ribbon cable that went to a potentiometer, and the potentiometer come with a cool knob on it. I was like, for $5, man, that's pretty good deal. The only thing I would check to make sure is that when you buy that, make sure your motor is going to be enough. This is going to hold enough amperage for your motor. And these motors are not using a lot of amps. But, I mean, just be cautious. And not, saying that too, you don't have to buy a 50-amp speed controller for a DC motor. So you're not going to, you might not need that for your setup. Like I said, the one I found on eBay was like, I think it was under $5. $5 for that board. Going back and looking at it now, I probably would have just done that. But I like building stuff, which is sometimes a problem. But, anywho, that's about it on that. Not to power it. What's going in the speed controller is just a 12-volt DC wall wart. And I'm pretty sure my wife or my kids are looking for their favorite toy's wall charger, and I've got it out here in the shop. And the luckily, though, I've got probably 20 of these things that I've, I could probably find one that fit whatever it is they're needing. But maybe they won't watch this video. Maybe not. The next thing I want to go over is this switch right here. The switch is a double pole, double throw, three position switch. What that means is, you know, if you're all the way down, this is going to spin, say, clockwise. If you're all the way up, it's going to spin counterclockwise. If you're in the center, it's going to be off. I bought this switch on eBay, and I believe it came in a two-pack. I checked the other day, and for two of these, it was $2.49. $2.49. It's a little smaller than I thought it was going to be. Like on the screen when I bought it, I thought it was going to be a little bit bigger. But anyways, it works. But, you know, I guess I should have checked sizes. And it's all a metric too, so I'm not really good on metric. But, you know, it's a lot smaller than I thought it was going to be anyways. That's about it on that. One thing I would change about that, though, and I'll go through this right quick, is instead of this being my polarity switch, which reverses my motor and does all that stuff, you should move this to the back here. And I saw somebody do that on YouTube, and I can't remember who it was after I built this, and it was a really good idea. Because, I mean, if you're sitting there and you're winding, say, one way, and you cut it off and you accidentally come back and go the other way, you're going to unwind everything you just wound on and make a mess. So you could move this switch to the back, have your polarity in the back, and just put a regular on-off switch right here. This switch, too, when you wire it, you can get online and look up a schematic or a pinout for the back of a double-pole, double-throw switch to reverse a motor, and it'll show you where wires go, what wires go to the motor, everything. It's pretty self-explanatory to wire that up. This little rod right here, I bought it at Lowe's. It's a 3/16 rod, and these are shaft couplings. Is that right? Shaft collars, I believe. I bought the rod and five collars, I want to say, for probably under $5 too, as well. And all I did was this rod goes through this side and it comes out to this side, and then I mounted a, I don't know if you can see that or not, but I mounted a collar right there, and I mounted a collar over here to hold this from moving back and forth, and then I mounted one on the outside for added protection. And then these two are adjustable to where I can line up with my bobbin so that I don't overshoot my pickup as I'm winding it. The other thing I would change on it would be this thing right here. It's a little close to the bobbin. Once you put the bobbin on here, I mean, it works, but it might be a little bit easier on me when I'm starting out. It works. I mean, you're this far from it as it's winding. If you could maybe build something out here a little bit to get you farther away from it, and maybe move this up a little bit to where, you know, you could be out here guiding it, and it's not as much of the wire's not popping as much as it's going through your hand. something you might want to add to yours. This counter, I would move it out of here and maybe mount it on the top. Maybe cut a hole here and mount it, or angle it, or do something, because the problem is when you're winding, even if you're sitting down, this not being a lighted digital counter, and you kind of got to kneel down, or you got to tilt your head to the side as you're winding to see kind of where you're at. Sometimes that can be, you know, anytime you're doing something with that can can mess you up. So that'd be something I would change. I'd move that up to the top or angle it or do something different with that. I'm going to cut it on right quick and let you see it run. See what you think about it. Let me make sure everything is off here to where everything. All right. So we're going to reset our counter. Make sure you can see that. Okay, you see the counter there now. All right. So I'm going to cut it on. Okay, you can hear the motor humming. The motor gets a little hum to it. And as you slowly cut it on, it'll start spinning. And one thing I found, once it starts spinning, you can slow it down and it'll still run. It's kind of like it won't want to start at first, but once it starts, it runs good. And so you spin it up, cut it up. For a second, I was wondering why the thing wasn't counting, but I had it on. It's got a pause button right here. But let me see if you can see that. So you can see it counting. It has a little bit of vibration to it, but it's not a lot. And you could probably go through. I'm going to show you here in a minute the bobbin to, kind of let you go through where maybe how you could build it, maybe do it different or something. But now if I want to go in reverse, flip the switch up. On reverse, and it's gonna count either way. It's not gonna affect it. And you can cut it off. Now, see what I'm saying about that switch? Now is if you're winding this way and you come up and cut it off, and I go back that way, I'm gonna unwind everything I just put on it. Or if I hit it, if I'm sitting here and I come up and I hit it by accident, it's gonna flip back. That might be something you want to change in yours. Let me show you this bobbin right quick. This is just a piece of half inch plywood, and I cut it out on my CNC machine, and it's just a square, basically. You could cut it out of a block of wood if you wanted to, however you want to build it. And I drilled a hole in the middle, and then I drilled a hole through the top, and then tapped it, and then just made it to where I could put this on there. And I mounted the magnet on it, and then I put a little bit of a counterbalance over here on this side, and it's not totally balanced at all, but I mean for what I, the speeds that I wrap at, it's really not affected me any. But you could take this thing and balance it however you wanted to, or make it out of something like MDF or something that's maybe a little more balanced and stuff. But that's really it. I mean, I went over the motor, $15 to $20, the counter $12.49, the speed controller was $5, this was $2, that was $5. So you could see where you could save a lot of money to get started with something and start making pickups. The wood on this thing is just some scrap pieces of plywood that I had laying around, and when I first built it and designed it, I figured I was going to need a motor mount, which I ended up not needing. And I was going to mount this, right in here to hold the motor. But I cut that hole. The hole was cut so good that when it stuck in there, it's held in there good. It ain't coming out to wind. I mean, enough to wind a pickup. So if you have any questions, just leave them in the comments. I really appreciate you watching my first YouTube video. If something's wrong on here, or if you see an idea that makes something better, leave me a comment or send me an email or anything. I don't care. Bad criticism, if you want to, I take it well. So if I did something totally wrong, please tell me, and just leave it in the comments. And I hope you subscribe. I'm gonna have some more videos. I'm gonna go through a lot of stuff that I've built in the shop and different tools and machinery that I've built to save money. That's the most important thing. Do what you love and save a little money in the same time. But thanks for watching, guys. I hope you have a good day.